Okay, because this door is gonna close after we start.
How long it will take?
1 hour. So for today, you can use our two bodies or everybody else's body if they also like. And you can use your five senses, touch, taste, look, hear, to research on in our corporal, start from our corporal alienation, in how we are alienated from between each other by our bodies. And with this way, eventually, we're going to discover other layers of alienation, and that's our goal. So I would like you, if anybody else wants to be a body, to be tested, or if anybody wants to keep the camera so I can not hold the camera myself and I can be the body. Please, just don't... That's anything, or...?
No, no. Film me?
Yes, you can film me or expressions. So you can come closer and touch, smell, use your five senses.
On you?
Yes, on us.
We are both here.
Or if anybody else wants to give his or her body, their body.
you want to sing?
No, no. I want to experience your voices.
Okay. We can hum.
Can you also dance? No. Just an idea.
We are the interpreters of this piece.
What's my name?
My name's
Ange Baranga.
I'm Jonas.
Would you like to shake hands?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Jacob.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Hey.
Hi.
Jacob.
Nice to meet you.
Yes.
Hi.
Lydia. Christian.
Christian.
Yes.
Hi.
Martin.
Martin.
Hi.
Hi.
Marcus.
Marcus?
Yeah.
Hey.
Hi. You see.
Lydia. You see.
Eva.
Olivia. Hey, Olivia.
Your name? Olivia?
Livia.
Livia.
Just okay. Hi.
Hello.
Livia?
Antonia.
Antonia. Livia?
Hey.
Hey. Ah, it is Antonia.
Hey.
No, okay. Yes.
Where are you from?
Huh?
Where are you from?
Sweden. Thank you.
Greeks mostly, because people who came to Greece to see Documenta, so it was multicultural as well. But the room was different, it was more inviting, more cool.
Many guys are belonging to the performance group?
Just the two of us.
Really?
Really?
She's allowed.
Research on the interpretation of this score.
Yeah.
are you talking to? The audience is your instrument. Am I supposed to take the audience to have an instrument?
It depends of in what you recognize the instrument or...
It doesn't really say something.
Yeah, because it's flexible. We can... Today we wear the instruments, but other days others wear instruments. Or we can discuss about who is the instrument of who and...
And we are supposed to understand by this how we are basically instrumentalized by the, I don't know, capitalism and technology. And mm-hmm. I mean, this is a big thing you're asking us.
Okay, we can discuss about it. It's not necessary that we interpret the whole score, but we can.
But this is not how you tell us, you see. It's not that you say discuss with us, but it says now you do something, now you instrumentalize the audience, you take the audience to do something.
Okay.
It's difficult.
Of course it's difficult.
Of course.
And now you make pictures. Yeah, so, yeah, we can discuss. But I don't think it doesn't really make sense what you write to me. Can you explain?
Of course, but do you also agree? Do you have the same questions?
Could we talk about it?
Yes, let's talk.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Talking is great.
Well, I agree on what she's saying, because the rules were not clear in the beginning that we could discuss, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Discussing would be a wonderful starting point. It's very difficult to start with touching. It's more easy to start with talking.
But isn't it interesting that it's so difficult?
Yeah, we
but
are.
But let's talk about
somehow
it.
Somehow we have become a no-touch society. That's a real problem, I think.
But I think this gives us frames. We have 1 hour, and we can skip the, like, what should we do? We could just jump into something that we desire to do, or that
you really
wish for.
Did you read it? Did
a little bit.
Yeah.
I didn't really
understand.
It's so complex.
Yeah. And it doesn't say really something.
What is it complicated?
Capitalism.
Yeah, it's such a big thing, you know.
Narcissism. When you like yourself very much, like Narcissus, that he fell inside the river, cuts his own, he was in love with himself.
Narcissism.
Okay.
I have no idea how to relate this to communication. I mean, communication is about overcoming narcissism, right? It's about crossing borders and joining with others and communicating.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea how to
maybe we need sometimes we need an excuse to not have to talk, or like, oh, they invite me to smell, or to cross the border of, okay, I can actually hug him if I want to. And that's not so often in where I come from, Norway, that you can go to a stranger and like, oh, you look friendly, do you want a hug? Or, you know, that's how I relate it to the individual.
Yeah,
mm.
Borders,
mm-hmm.
somehow.
Yeah, but I see also this of not clear rules, that we want to have sense, like make sense of things, and that it's kind of nice to not have to do that also. Or to make sense together.
But I felt kind of uneasy because there were no clear rules when we started, so everybody was somehow waiting.
Is freedom what makes you feel a bit uncomfortable? When
it
you're
was
given.
Too much freedom, I think.
Mm-hmm.
For my understanding, it felt uneasy. But hugging, that felt very good.
Mm-hmm.
That was a nice invitation. Greeting you and welcoming you somehow. That felt nice.
Can I ask you? Because you were the first person to actually come to us. while reading the text and then seeing what we're doing, did you try to match the two of them to find a purpose on that?
Yeah, that's what I did, because in the beginning, I mean, if you want me to hug or to sense or whatever, why don't you come to me and you just do it? You try.
Mm-hmm.
And so there is a big thing to do in words, written on a white paper. And now you stand there and say, okay, we're here. You can do whatever you want. If I don't have an impulse, I even feel a little bit like, oh, I'm doing wrong. I don't have this impulse. I have the impulse to touch you because you offered. But then, okay, that was it. That was fine.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I would have to have an answer or a play. And then I read this and I thought, my God, I have to do something. I get in stress. Actually, it's nice because what I find out is I find out a lot about myself. We can see you want hugs, you want like, hey, and that's very beautiful. And I'm like here discussing and doing a big thing and making a problem.
Does anybody feel that she's making a problem?
No, for myself. I don't think I'm bothering anybody. So please tell me that. No. I lost my husband now.
Why did he
call? He said to me that he doesn't think there's more happening.
It's more sparkling.
Isn't that also what we expect of of coming somewhere, that we want something out of it, or like, why do we do that?
I think expecting is coming from the out, because we are watching out because getting an input, and there wasn't any input. It was really difficult for me also because the sheet and it was all, and there was not more input from your side, and you are the artist.
We are artists, but at this point we are interpreting Matin's score. So
the artist
who
is Matin.
Developed this work is somebody that who is not here.
For me, what was missing was the ritual to get introduced to each other. We are all strangers in coming together. And it's difficult.
It's just what we are asked to. I got also really stressed and somehow scared. I was like watching her. Her it was like so natural. And yeah, it was a really stressful situation, but I understand what can come out of it. But I was not able to do anything about it.
Why do you think it was stressful? What was the factor that made it stressful?
For me personally, it's like sometimes hard to overcome this the space every person has. For me, it's hard to let someone in. And for me, it's also hard to enter someone else's. So I could not act, really.
For me, another problem, I think just, yeah, the words on the sheet, they promise and that you expect something and you feel really bound to these, I don't know, big words, and at the same time you have to overcome yourself.
I'm sorry, I need to stop. I'm sorry, can you please give us your feedback?
But I just give you a feedback. For me there was no input and I came here to see.
Could we actually had helped you in order to stay?
No, because now I was here like 45 minutes and it happened nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not enough. I want to see more, and that's why I'm here.
Okay. You too?
For me, honestly, I don't get it. So, I mean, I get the concept and everything, but, well, I don't know what to do. So, I know I can touch, I can lick, I can smell or anything, but I don't know why.
Can you help him? Maybe the ones that participated can actually make him understand?
What would you like?
I don't know.
I would like you to stand like, because I saw you as a couple and I found it very beautiful. Mm-hmm. Just stand there for a minute as a couple. It was beautiful. And the other two girls sitting, you're still sitting there. And the other girls, what's so, such a nice picture, you know, to have a little art here, like couples and a nice picture.
Do you have a camera?
No, she didn't go.
No, but I think I want to go now. For me, it's enough.
I'm sorry I interrupted you.
I think I've said what I wanted to say.
I'm
just lost
hear,
in
so
words in the end, so
okay.
That's all right.
That's special, no? That we now can look at each other and stay like this.
Mm. Well, if you would have more Jägermeister, then I think it
would. Maybe just have a box of beer here next time, or wine.
But I have a question.
Good story, good starting point.
When you saw me, do you ever, what was your first impression of me? And because I understood it as you saw me open and it's about like love. Or I'm curious to hear if you want to tell.
Okay, the first impression was that I thought you belonged to these guys. Mm-hmm. You had this white thing, right?
Yeah.
I saw you outside already. And I talked with my husband and said, oh, well, she could belong to the play. And then I found you very beautiful in your openness when you said you want a hug and beautiful young flower like this.
You asked me?
Thank you. I also like when she walked around with the camera.
Yeah.
People smile at the camera.
Yeah.
So game started. I think maybe we are also shy because of the camera. It's a different situation.
Yeah. It's starting about tomorrow. I hope I will be not here tomorrow. And this is supposed to be on a...
Tomorrow it's going to be projected on the screen, only tomorrow. And it's going to be on YouTube forever.
YouTube.
Till YouTube dies.
Yeah, maybe our behavior changes with these online
mediums. Do you believe that it will be easier for you to actually come closer and participate if it wasn't for the camera?
Absolutely.
Yes. Or maybe is it just fixed camera somewhere, so you might as well forget about it more easily than if someone holds it all the time and walks around it, so it always attracts attention.
But as we said at the introduction, our goal is to deal with all these mediations, and the camera is another type of mediation that is embedded in our everyday experience of life. So we try to research on this social space by having all these problems, by having a difference in the languages that we speak. We some people speak German, we are from Greece, other people are from other countries. This is also another boundary. The camera is also another boundary. The distance of our bodies are also a boundary.
Yeah, but it's not a thing if something is recorded and fixed for a long time, and at the same time asking people to overcome distance and to act more freely. It makes it harder.
It puzzles me. It puzzles me because I understand me feeling weird because I was the person that was gonna be touched, licked, smelled. But honestly, I don't understand why it would be difficult for you to come and do something to me in a good way, like touch me or kiss me or pat my hair. How can anybody be exposed by being kind to another person, by expressing his presence? You can only understand reality by using all five senses of you. I don't know, some Greek dead guy told them, but it's true. You cannot be sure that the room exists if you not touch, see, smell, and use your senses to know that the room is there. So for me, this experience was very, very interesting. And I do believe that the corporal alienation that may be given as a negative attribute to Northerns, but I mean, if you're from Norway, and you were the second person to come and participate, and you were so open, and we are supposed to be the Northerns and be more open, and we don't care if we touch each other on the buses anywhere. But I do believe that the first step is corporal alienation, and if we get past that, then we can discuss. That was important for me, that first we hit the step that's the materiality, and then we go to the spiritual, because the spiritual is easy for us to talk to each other. It's not that easy to share, to be sincere, but it's for me very important that we understand that out there, touching each other in any way can be harmful, but can at the same time be very, very useful to know and understand someone else.
But that's a beautiful idea. Just what I would need is that you touch me as well. Like if I touch you, I want to be touched as well.
Understandable. Yeah. That's why we actually, the idea was that if you want to touch somebody in this room, and I really like that when I noticed that nobody was touching nobody at some point, the persons that were in couple, they immediately hug each other. Mm-hmm. And I look around and I see couples touching each other at that point. But you could have asked me to touch you.
That's true.
To me, it is that everybody is looking, and then I think that if I was to do something, then that everybody would think, oh, why exactly that thing? Or like, yeah, wait for a moment, or like, why and when, mm-hmm. how and what, mm-hmm. and everybody looking, everyone's like, just freeze because it's too much. Yeah.
So you felt that you were looked by the others of the room and not the other of the camera?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Here, because then it's, okay, we have this, and then it's like to wait for a moment, to wait. Yeah, waiting for each other. And also, I get these questions of like, why would I want to do that?
Mm-hmm.
But like the hug is something that's, because I liked mm-hmm. that, and I can like justify that in a way. But yeah, like licking ear is like, yeah, that was cool experience. But then I was like, I kind of want to do that back. But then like, I would think that everybody would think, why would you want to do that?
Like, do it. No.
Your chest.
Oh no. But then I would feel like if I was going to do that now, that I would do it to please you.
Yeah.
Can you do it to please me? I ask you.
I think that.
Yes.
I think that today started being difficult and it was an estranging experience at the start asking you to come closer. But as the time passed by, I saw that more and more people go into this conversation. And actually, we came up to this, we call it the sincere moment, when we have crossed a boundary, and then we all are together more easy to share with each other. And this is a kind of a motif that, it's something that happens very often here, that after the resolution of what we're happening, what's happening, and we come closer and we get into a sharing and sincere mode, which is very interesting for me at least, because there are so many views on the same matter, and every person has a different kind of involvement. And I appreciate it.
I came here because I think it's a good idea to make such a performance. But I feel ambiguous about this situation and this words. Yeah. So it's for me. Yeah, it was the right decision to come here, but also it's for me, for example, too important also to say that I think it's it says something. I wonder what is about these words, what is not for me so okay.
In what way?
So it's a little bit like these words came from a teacher. He wants to show us that how we are instrumentalized from capitalism, and so and this is this purpose to show something like to be taught. So I think that there are very important topics in this text. So I like something about this text. On the other side, there's something quite strange for me and important also.
Besides the text, the experience that you lived in this space, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, when I came, I was a little bit tired, so I didn't like to go too much into action. Yeah, I think for me it's an interesting thing to go into such an open space. So what will happen? That's very interesting. So I decided to come here and not to go to other places.
Do you think we have achieved the collective subject?
reinforce it. Tell it in one word, then I tell you.
What is the collective subject?
Yeah.
I have an interpretation, but I would like you to hear you also.
My impression is that it's about distance and about getting to